So joining me for another bite-sized Science Week conversation is University of Tasmania and DECRA fellow Vipul Gupta. Thanks for joining me, Vipul.
Thank you, Sam, for this opportunity, and it's a pleasure talking to you.
Yeah, nice to catch up with you again. How's life treating you down in Tasmania? Most of the people I've had on for these Science Week conversations have been from Melbourne, and you know they've got a lot more restrictions in place than us. So how's life been down in?
Yeah, well, Tasmania is having a bit of a luck, you can say, because of them being isolated. So yeah, we don't have any active case for more than 100 days now. We don't have any community transmission. So yeah, we are in a much better situation than rest of Australia, so to speak. And because we are isolated by ourselves and we're trying to keep that by keeping our border closed and things like that. So yes, Tasmania is in a pretty good state in terms of COVID, and that's why the restrictions have been much relaxed in terms of gathering, in terms of coming to university and working and things like that. So that's pretty good. Yeah, but still, as everyone in the world is affected by COVID, we too are. We don't get any students, we don't get our deliveries in time. All our collaborations have been pretty much in pipeline and they're stuck. So yeah, like everyone, we are affected with COVID, but I would say a bit less compared to others, fortunately. Yeah.
Difficult times indeed for all, but yeah. I want to focus on science because it is Science Week. Yep. So first of all, what's your area of research and science?
So we are currently working on 3D printing novel materials, such as 3D printing multi-level porosity glass. So 3D printing of plastics, polymers, and metals to an extent is a bit more understood, and there are various methods and techniques to do that. But 3D printing glass is still quite novel, and still there is not a lot of understanding on how we can print glass, and especially no one has still figured out a convenient way of printing multi-level porosity glass. And why we are interested in multi-level porosity glass or silica structures is because they have implications in every field, ranging from health to energy to analytical chemistry, environmental analysis, etc. So yeah, so that's what we are trying to do. We are trying to use 3D printing to make multi-level porosity glass and then use it for different applications.
So what attracted you to a career in science?
So if I have to sum it up in a word, I would say curiosity. So since childhood, I have been curious, and my hobby was to solve riddles, puzzles, things like that, and basically just coming up with new solutions, working around barriers and things like that. And as I grew up, I learned that science is a pretty great tool and pretty important tool to have when you want to solve problems, basically. And that's what encouraged me into science. Like during my undergraduate, I did a few projects, and that bought me, that gave me some experience that how we can use science and how we can use these tools to solve pretty major or socioeconomically important problems. So that's what attracted him towards science, that if I can learn science, if I can make a career in science, then I might be able to solve some important aspects. And I enjoy learning new things. That's the other thing probably.
So how did you then get involved in that particular area of science and research that you're now working in?
It has been a long story, to be true. So I did my undergrad in pharmaceutical sciences. And when I was studying pharmaceutical sciences, I realized that I'm more interested towards physical aspect of it, material aspect of it, rather than the biological aspect. That's why I did my master's in materials engineering. When I was doing my master's in materials engineering, I realized that there is only enough we can do with experiments, and we need to go into computational modeling. So I worked in computational modeling for 2 years. And then this opportunity came up where I was getting to use my material science and computational modeling experience to do a PhD in 3D printing analytical devices. So basically that brought together some of my previous expertise, and it was a fascinating field. 3D printing 5 years back was quite new. Even now it is, it's only 3 decades old, and it has been exponentially increasing. So yeah, so that fascinated me to come to do a PhD in 3D printing analytical devices. And when I was doing my PhD, I saw a few challenges around 3D printing, and I tried to work as my way around, like try to find out solutions to those. And that's what prompted me to write a DECRA proposal. And then since it got funded, so now I'm working on it as a DECRA fellow.
So I imagine, you know, your job is very varied and, you know, you do many different things, but I wonder what's the most exciting part of your job?
So still the most exciting part of my job I would say is still that problem solving thing, which made me come to science. So I still, when we sit together with our colleagues, peers, mentors, and try to solve problems, try to find solutions, that's what excites me, and finding a solution to that problem. And most 90% of the time it doesn't work, the solution which we come up with, but yeah, that's the whole fascination about that, proposing new solutions to problems which everyone is facing, and try to come up with different ways, and just that brainstorming session, basically it just gets that kid in me excited again to work around barriers. Because so when you come from resource limited settings like me, you get to evolve, you get to have that intrinsic nature of working around barriers, and that's what I get to do in my job, and I have started liking it rather than hating it. That's what you can say.
So as this is Science Week, I'm wondering if you can offer some advice to maybe some future scientists out there.
So one piece of advice I would say is keep learning. Basically, keep moving, keep learning. So as I said, I consider science as one of the tools to solve problems. And the more tools you have in your toolbox is always good. As I said, like my career, if I look back, I did my undergraduate in pharmaceutical sciences, master's in materials engineering, computational modeling, then PhD in 3D printing and additive chemistry. When I was doing it, there was nothing joining them together. They all seemed haphazard. They all seemed just whatever came my way, kind of. The background story I had in my mind was I was being passionate and I was following what I like, even though that meant jumping from one field to another. But now in the hindsight, all that worked out, since science don't work in isolation. No field is discrete from any another field. Everything is interdisciplinary. And a lot of times I've seen that a problem which we face in one field is a common knowledge in another. So pharmacy and food science, for example, there are a lot of knowledge available in food science, since it's many more years older than pharmacy, that the same knowledge can be easily exported to pharmacy, and same in 3D printing and material science. Eventually 3D printing relies on material science knowledge, and there's a lot of common knowledge available in material science which just directly exports to 3D printing. So keep learning new techniques, keep learning new fields, don't give up, keep moving ahead. And if you are getting scholarships in your master's and PhD, that's essentially paying you to learn. And that really never happens. Like, you usually pay to learn. And if you're getting paid to learn, there's no reason why you should not learn as many things, as many techniques you can. And keep putting yourself in uncomfortable situations. By uncomfortable situations, I mean, don't think that you don't know this, or you haven't studied this, or you can't work in this. If you go and work in that field, you will learn it. You can learn anything, and just keep learning, basically. Keep accumulating as many tools as you can.
Great. Well, thanks for the advice, and thanks for joining us for this Science Week conversation. Best down in Tasmania as we try to manage this difficult time that everyone's going through.
Hopefully, like every bad situation passes, this one passes too, hopefully soon, and then everything is back to normal, and we can meet everyone in conferences and meetings and do everything we used to love doing. So let's hope for the best.
Fingers crossed. Hopefully we'll see you up at Wollongong, or I'll be down in Tasmania sometime soon for a conference.
Can't wait to catch up.
Thanks, Biffle.
Thank you.